Hey guys! That's not my intro. Let's do that again. 1, 2, 3. What is up, Marie Squad? So today I am going to be doing my first ever makeup tutorial. It's not a makeup tutorial, but get ready with me. I'm kind of in a quick pace right now. So yeah, but today we're going to go for a glowy skin. And I love that jazz. So let's do it. So the first step in my makeup get ready with me, we're just gonna call this get ready with me. I'm just gonna put on this mini headband. Boom. I love this so much because it's like fluffy here, very soft. And I love the mini ears. So now that I got all my hair tucked away, first step for face. The lighting is so bad right now. But anyways, the first step I'm going to do is I'm going to cleanse my face for a nice palette. So I'm going to use this Fuji Baby Wipes. This is an alcohol-free like wet tissue. So I'm going to use this to just wipe my face, clean off stuff. So here's the tissue. It's wet and I'm just going to go in. But I'm just gonna rub over my face, make sure I clean it, and it's kind of like a refreshing layer to start with. Please try to use alcohol-free like baby wipes because you're gonna wipe it all over your face, and I don't think alcohol should be on your face that much. Now that we're done, I feel very refreshed. We're gonna put on some primer, and my favorite primer is this one, Pink by Pure Beauty Soul Blur Cream. Yeah, so as the name suggests, it's gonna blur out your skin. So I'm just gonna take like a squeeze like that. I'm going to just tap like so, and then I'm just gonna blend out with my fingers. So. See, it's very blurring. It just a regular primer. My face is a little bit sticky and ready for some foundation. L'Oreal True Match Satin Smooth Liquid Foundation. I am in the shade N2 Nude Porcelain. Okay, for the next step is concealer, and I have two that I'm gonna use today. I normally use this one, which you can see that I've been using a lot. But anyways, and I'm using this is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. And this is how it looks like. This is in the shade 15, Fair, I think, yeah. And the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind, Instant Age Rewind Concealer. This is in the shade, if I can find the shade, I don't know. I think this is the lightest shade. To me, I don't find this really mind-blowing. I'm just really telling myself this is good. So now that I have done with my base, normally I would just go in with my powder and set it, done, eye makeup time. But I want to try cream contour. So I have this from, I don't even know the brand name. Like, what is that name? Focus, please, focus, focus. It's this like Bulga. Anyways, it's Face 109 Stick. Well, it has a concealer and a bronzer. So I'm gonna try that today. So yeah, I'm just gonna take the dark side. That is stupid. The dark side. And I'm just gonna go like that. Boom. Just align like that. And then my temples. Okay, let's take our glasses off. Look, three. Like so. Anyways, so. And the nose. This stick is really nice when applying it. But we gonna see if it really works. So I have my beauty blender here and I'm just gonna blend it out. She looking nice. Okay, a little bit more better. So here it is, all blend out. I think it looks fine. Now we just have the temple to blend. And it blends pretty easy. And I think the color is pretty nice. It doesn't look like muddy or gray. It's definitely about gray. Ooh, looks good. I like that. Okay, so I'm really having really low expectation because I've never seen my face like nose contoured properly. I just have like this line of dirt on my face. So, yeah. This is the result. Do you see this? It's kind of like not good. It's kind of like just blend it out. So yeah, maybe I blend it too much. I don't even know. I'm not used to contouring. I'm just used to bronzing my face. But okay, I'm not mad at it. So here is the finished look with the contour. Let's do a little bit highlighting, just a little, just to try it out. So here's the highlighting, and it's just like a light cream. I'm gonna do my nose and just highlight the part that I think is a little bit too much, like so. Not too much, like there and there, just to bring back the light. Okay, I think we're blended and now we're ready for powder. Everybody's favorite, the L'Oreal Mercier translucent powder. This is an all-time favorite of everyone's. I'm sure everybody has this. So yeah, there's the powder. I'm just gonna take my beauty blender and just gonna make first. Using this really big brush, very thick, this brush, to powder my face. So I'm just gonna dip it in my powder. My powder's flying everywhere because I have a bowl right there. But anyways, my powder is literally flying everywhere except on my brush. I'm really confused with that sentence, so let's just cut that off. So I'm just gonna take my brush and dip it in my powder and just go through and set my face. That is too much. Okay, so for the eyebrows, I'm going to be using this E2D drawing eyebrow pencil. So yeah, it has a pencil on one side and a spoolie on the other side. So here's my tutorial how to do my eyebrows. So first I take the spoolie part. Now I'm pretty lucky to have kind of hairy eyebrows, if you would call it. Like I have eyebrows, but what I hate about them is that, like, do you see like my eyebrow? Which eyebrows am I gonna choose? Oh, let's go this way. Do you see like this eyebrow is like this? The front has very thick hair and it's like black. But when you go to the ends of my eyebrows, it's like empty. So yeah, I'm gonna fill that in. And I'm just gonna draw a line underneath. And I try to make my eyebrows not look too thick because they're already quite thick. And if it's more thick, I just think I'm gonna have sharpie eyebrows. So I just draw lines on the top and the bottom. And then I have kind of like an arch, so I just draw straight down. And I try to make my eyebrows a little bit longer by just making it more thin and long. So once I got like the outline done, I'm just gonna fill it in like really roughly, like so. Do you see? I know it looks like a mess, but then I take my spoolie and then I brush the product around my eyebrows. And I love this step just because it gives me an even amount of product and I'm not using too much product. I don't have sharp eyebrows and it just blends everything in. Now I have a little mess here, just ignore that. But yeah, that's how I do my eyebrows. You can cover it with concealer later, but this is really how I do it. Yeah, so I'm gonna repeat that on my other side of the eyebrow, my other eyebrow, and I'll be right back. So, and we're done. So to carve out my eyebrows, I'm using this flat eyeshadow brush. Everybody has this brush. And I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer again, and I'm just gonna take the applicator, and I'm just gonna apply it to the brush, like so. So I have this much amount of concealer on my brush, so I'm just gonna use it as an eyeshadow base. So I just take my brush, and I just apply some, do you see, on my eyeshadow brush, and then I just brush the concealer onto my eye, blending it. I know some people like to use like beauty blenders too. I just think I like this more. It's more detailed and stuff. So yeah. We're gonna cover our eyebrows. So, get the brush and just go on the sides where I wanna delete any product. And I'm just gonna brush it in. Make sure my eyebrows are on fleek. Do you guys even use that word anymore? I don't know. Thank you. let's jump on to the eyeshadow part. So I'm gonna be using this palette. So this is the Kathy Doll Nude Me eyeshadow palette in the number one, Nude. So here's the color. The pigmentation is pretty good. So I'm gonna start off with this fluffy crease brush. I'm just gonna go in with this color, like a very warm brown. I'm just gonna apply it to my crease. I'm just gonna put it on my crease. As you see, that's a very nice brown color. I'm gonna take this fluffy like brush and just gonna blend and buff out just like that, and just blend everything nicely into the crease like that. Okay, so my brush has a little bit of pink left over, so it made my brown go a little bit pinker. I'm gonna use this color, like a very nude pink, but this is a shimmery shadow. It's like a nude pink. Oh god, wrong brush. Using this brush that I have, I'm just gonna apply it to this part, like the outer corner. I think take that color again and in the inner corner. I think this is called Halo Eyes. Slept too much. We go up and down, we go up and down. I'm on this rollercoaster ride. We fall back sometimes, we fall back sometimes. I'm on this rollercoaster ride. In this rollercoaster ride. Okay, we're back. Oh, now I have this highlighter. Then I'm gonna take my pencil brush and just gonna dip it in the highlighter. And then I'm just gonna apply it to my inner corners. Like so. Do you see that? She's popping. Really popping from a far distance. And the brow bone. Oh yes, honey. On the other side. Now that we have highlighted the inner corners and the brow bone, I'm gonna take some eyeliner, and this is the Maybelline Hyper Sharp Power Black eyeliner. Now it's time for lashes. I'm gonna curl them using this eyelash curler. And I'm using the Maybelline Hyper Curl Volume Express mascara. And this is the Easy Wash version. The next step is bronzer. So I'm gonna use this Max Factor Pressed Powder in the shade 6. As you can see, I've been using it a lot. And the brush that I use is this one. Adding bronziness to my face. Next step is blush, and I'm using this like circular blush brush, and I'm using the number 7 powder blusher in the color Apricot Blossom, which is kind of like this peachy pink. I do apply blush on my nose to make me look like sunshine. So the next step is highlight. Ugh. So again, using that Too Faced highlighter. Taking my bronzer brush again, and I'm using like the side here, and then I just go in like this, and then see the part of this right here, and then I just go in. Glowing, honey. She is glowing. And the last step we have for today is the lip. This KA Lip Care chapsticks in the scent strawberry. And there we have it. The finished look. Let me stop.
We still got a lot of bloopers. Enjoy.
Give me a second, I need to have some camera issues. Hello? Okay. Are you ready? I hope you are straight, nice and straight, please. Okay. The frick. Okay. I can't see the camera. Give me a second. I'm having a lot of trouble right now. Okay. Some on, like so. And I'm just gonna go on parts of my face. The first thing that I found out with this new beauty blender that I'm using is that it absorbs everything. And when I mean everything, I mean everything. So I'm just gonna switch to a new one. So I'm using a new beauty blender. This one is, apparently it is latex free. So that's gonna be cool. Again, just dabbing some foundation on. Oh my god, that is not okay. Is going way wrong. Okay, here's the foundation. Dab on the face. Oh my god, this sponge is definitely dense. And when I mean definitely dense, it is like punching me in the face. And it's absorbing my makeup. While we're waiting for our lashes to be dry, I'm gonna use this eyeshadow pencil with brush. This is from Miniso. It's like an eyeshadow. This is a golden color, and there's a brush at the back. So, I'm just gonna take it, and I have no place for this to go, so let's just skip it. This one.
doctor knows